Good morning, you guys. As you can see, it is raining. And yesterday and today are literally complete opposites. Yesterday was like the worst quality air day I've ever seen. The whole state was covered in smoke, and at about 3 o'clock in the afternoon yesterday, it started raining, and it amazed me at how quickly the air cleared up. Like within 2 hours, it was like the smoke was gone and the sky was clearing, and the air was better. Like to me, it was a lesson, like how quickly things can go from like the worst ever to good, to better, you know, with a little rain, a cleansing, you know. Speaking of that, we are on to Nehemiah chapter 4 today, so I'm just gonna dive right in. When Sanballat heard that we were rebuilding the wall, he became angry and was greatly incensed. He ridiculed the Jews, and in the presence of his associates and the army of Samaria, he said, "What are these feeble Jews doing? Will they restore their walls? Will they offer sacrifices? Will they finish in a day? Can they bring the stones back to life from those heaps of rubble, burning as they are?" Tobias and the Ammonite, who was at his side, said, "What they are building, if even a fox climbed up on it, he would break down their walls of stone. Hear us, O God, for we are despised. Turn their insults back on their own heads. Give them over as plunder in a land of captivity. Do not cover up their guilt or blot out their sins from their sight, for they have thrown insults in the face of the builders." So we rebuilt the wall till all of it reached half its height, for the people worked with all their heart. But when Sanballat, Tobiah, the Arabs, the Ammonites, and the men of Ashdod heard that the repairs to Jerusalem's walls had gone ahead, and that the gaps were being closed, they were very angry. They all plotted together to come and fight against Jerusalem and stir up trouble against it. But we prayed to our God and posted a guard day and night to meet his threat. Meanwhile, the people in Judah said, "The strength of the laborers is giving out. There is so much rubble that we cannot rebuild the wall." Also, our enemies said, "Before they know it or see us, we will be right there among them, and we will kill them and put an end to this work." Then the Jews who lived near them came and told us 10 times over, "Wherever you turn, they will attack us." Therefore, I stationed some of the people behind the lowest points of the wall at the exposed places, posting them by families with their swords, spears, and bows. After I looked things over, I stood up and said to the nobles, the officials, and the rest of the people, "Don't be afraid of them. Remember the Lord, who is great and awesome, and fight for your brothers, your sons and your daughters, your wives and your homes." When our enemies heard that we were aware of their plot and that God had frustrated it, we all returned to the wall, each to his own work. From that day on, half of my men did the work, while the other half were equipped with spears, shields, bows, and armor. The officers posted themselves behind all of the people of Judah who were building the wall. Those who carried materials did their work with the one hand and held a weapon in the other. And each of the builders wore his sword at his side, and he worked. But the man who sounded the trumpet stayed with me. Then I said to the nobles, officials, and the rest of the people, "The work is extensive and spread out, and we are widely separated from each other along the wall. Wherever you hear the sound of the trumpet, join us there. Our God will fight for us." So we continued the work with half the men holding spears from the first light of dawn till the stars came out. I love that. At that time, I also said to the people, have every man and his helper stay inside Jerusalem at night, so they can serve us and guard by night and work and workmen by day. Neither I nor my brothers nor my men nor the guards with me took off our clothes. Each had his weapon, each when he went for water. Wow. You know, there were haters even back in Old Testament times. But the haters didn't just throw, like, you know, an insult on a tweet. They were, like, you know, fighting for to the death. This is intense. It's like, I have to look into it more, but why is Sanballat so against this? You know, so against the wall? Why mock it and be so contrary? You know, like, what's in it for him? And maybe that's something too, like, have you ever had an enemy and you're just like, I don't really understand why you hate me or why you don't like me or why you want to bully me or be mean to me? Like, I don't understand. Like, you know what I mean? Like, that's what it feels like with this for them, is it's like, they're doing something so noble and it's so hard. And, you know, it's like they have to work with one hand and hold a spear in another, you know? And it's like, but I think that's such a commentary for now too. Like, I think that that's where a lot of us are, you know, we're working on one side of our lives to rebuild. And on the other side, we're fighting our battles, you know? Whatever that might be. And, you know, so I can relate to that. I think another thing to note too is the communication. I mean, I just had chocolate, sorry. just a little side note. It's in my teeth too. Every morning I wake up, the first thing I do is drink water and eat a little piece of chocolate, a dark chocolate, like high cacao. Like 80% dark chocolate. But I don't know. There's just something about that, like doing that the first thing in the morning, that it's like a ritual. I love doing it. Anyway, a little side note. But, you know, the communication in chapter 4, you know, it's like off the charts how well they communicate. And just that they're fighting for each other and that they really believe in this cause together. And it really matters to them. And so I guess it challenges me because I'm kind of an independent person and I like to do everything by myself, but I am realizing the blessing in, like, relying on other people and being interdependent. And so whatever you're passionate about building, try to find other like-minded people that are just as passionate as you, and then communicate really well and fight for what you believe in. That's what this chapter tells me. All right, you guys, thanks for tuning in again. I'll see you soon.